2005, the European Cultural Foundation organized a series of meetings with artists and intellectuals from the Western Balkans under the title of Balkan Reflection Group. The goal of the Reflection Group was to examine the role of arts and culture in the conflicts of former Yugoslavia and also exploring their potential contribution to regional and European integration. Its findings were collected in the publication The Heart of the Matter. Following the Reflection Group meetings, the participants came to the conclusion that a fund supporting cultural cooperation both within and with the region would be a good way to acknowledge the passion and potential of the Balkans' cultural sector. Additionally, it would stimulate regional and EU integration and help advocate for cultural policy improvements at local and regional level. And so in 2006, the Balkan Incentive Fund for Culture was set up with the financial support of the Open Society Foundations and the International Humanist Development Organization, HIFOS. In its inception year, the BIFC, as the fund was abbreviated, also received one-off support from the Swiss Agency for Development and Cooperation, the King Baudouin Foundation, and the Dutch Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Among the artists and cultural managers of the Reflection Group, one of the participants stood out for coming from a completely different field. Wolfgang Petrich, a Slovenian-born Austrian diplomat who had been high representative in Bosnia and Herzegovina, ambassador in Belgrade and former Rambouillet Agreement negotiator, enthusiastically agreed to participate in the Reflection Group.
I realized how traumatic the consequences of the war in former Yugoslavia have been and how they have affected the arts and the artists there. On the other hand, I was really very positively surprised and elated to see how, for example, an Albanian artist in Belgrade spoke Serbian and how they could communicate with each other. Something like a cultural Yugosphere, if I may call it such a way, existed there and that we could build upon it. It is a very good idea to have it right smack in the middle. And to be in Sarajevo, this is of course one of my, how should I say, domovina. For me, Bosnia, Sarajevo is like part of my own being. And this, in the middle of the Balkans, I think is a very good sign. You can work within the region, and I expect, above all, that the contacts go beyond the region. Feel as part of this Europe that we at ECF mean when we talk about Europe. We do not mean the European Union alone. This is part of Europe.
One of the very first grants awarded under the BIFC went to the project Museum of Broken Relationships, run by Zagreb-based artist Olinka Vištica and Dražen Grubišić, in cooperation with organizations from Serbia, Macedonia and Bosnia-Herzegovina. The project consisted of a collection of objects that symbolized the broken relationship of an individual. And then, with the help of the BIFC, the project was further developed in the Western Balkans. People from all over the region donated their objects and personal stories with such dedication that soon the collection grew into an impressive body of work, which was physically exhibited in Zagreb and the project partners' countries. This caught great international attention, and soon the collection traveled all over the world. In 2010, what had once started as a small project grew into an actual museum, now one of the main landmarks of the city of Zagreb.
Pa muzej prekinutih veza je sigurno projekt koji je onako dramatično učvrstio moje uvjerenje koliku snagu mogu imati i kultura i umjetnost i na koji način mogu uistinu promijeniti ljudske živote i učiniti ih boljim u najširem mogućem smislu. Kako je muzej putovao po raznim zemljama. Mi smo usprkos tog imena prekinutih veza toliko novih veza iskovali cijelo to vrijeme i zapravo shvatili da neke univerzalne poruke stvarno prelaze sve granice i tu nema nekih prepreka jezika, kulture, religija i tako dalje. U trenutku kada smo odlučili aplicirati na grant BFC-a, mi smo bili u vrlo osjetljivom trenutku razvoja projekta.
To da je netko to prepoznao, da je imao hrabrosti nam dati grant i pustiti nas da to napravimo, to je stvarno fenomenalna stvar. Jer od toga je krenulo. Mi da nismo gostovali tih, da nismo obišli taj krug po bivšoj Jugi i da nismo na taj način imali tu slobodu jer smo imali financije za sebe, da uđemo u to, pitanje jako, jako je upitno kako bi se sve dalje razvijalo.
In 2012, ECF and its partner Open Society Foundations decided it was time to take another step. After 6 years of managing the BIFC from Amsterdam, where the ECF is located, the time has come to transfer the fund to the region.
From the beginning, the fund was an international fund with a consortium of several partners, including the Dutch government. So it made a lot of sense to have the management outside of the region, possibly with some distance and neutrality, not even geographically, but also linguistically. And given that one of the partners was also the Dutch government, having the fund in the Netherlands did make a lot of sense at that time. In the summer of 2012, an open call was launched to invite proposals from organizations who would be interested in managing the fund. The Open Society Foundation and European Cultural Foundation joined together in a selection committee, and four proposals were invited to elaborate their ideas. Art Angle was selected as the strongest of these proposals. What we felt is that they represented a keen interest and covered the entire region. We're looking seriously at where gaps might be found in the region, and their enthusiasm and energy to move the fund to Sarajevo seemed infectious.
And so as of July 2013, the Sarajevo-based organization Art Angle will take over the full management and responsibility of the Balkan Incentive Fund for Culture. One of their first decisions has been to change the name of the fund into Balkans Art and Culture Fund.
The fund's name is clearly European Cultural Foundation's brand. So we thought that with the rebranding of the fund towards the Balkans Arts and Culture Fund, it would open up the fund to future interested investors in culture to the region much more. And in order to develop this fund as a self-reliant institution, we primarily need to think about diversification of funding. So basically using the European Cultural Foundation's commitment to culture in the region only as a seed money to its development and growth in the future. We are called Art Angle Balkans Culture Development, where Art Angle implies clearly the position or the point of view from which we work. Balkans indicates our regional scope. Culture is the field of operation and development is actually the reason why we have gathered together in the Art Angle. There are Petra Bischoff, Oliver Musovic, Samra Tozo and myself, and we work from Skopje, Belgrade and Sarajevo respectively. It is clear that the challenges we are having in political, economic or social sphere inevitably influence the work in culture. However, what makes the work in culture possibly more challenging is that it has never been at the top of political agendas. And what is even more complex for the independent culture is that it has always been at the margins of the cultural sector itself. I'm purposefully not talking about funding because it is so obvious, but we think that gaining a genuine recognition of the importance of culture in the overall development would bring about sustainable funding in the future.
We hope that the enthusiasm that Art Engel has exhibited will certainly spread and that it will bring on other funders and help grow the fund. ECF continues to be there, but we would like to see it a much larger one. And the organization Art Engel has great ambitions. We support those ambitions and we hope that they will continue into the coming years.
Be creative, be open, reach out to the artists and feel that you are the stakeholder of the most important part of our European identity, and this is culture.